So student, our next punctuation mark is, which is known as sentence dividers. They are comma. One is comma. So let's talk about comma. Comma introduces the shortest pause in a sentence. It is used in the following situations. So the following situation, what following situations are there? Let's discuss. First of all, it is separating words in series. Like you are having math, science, English, Hindi, lots of notebooks or books. So how you will write? If you are saying like that, we have to study math, science, English. But there is no pause. No, you are studying math, science, English. Like that, if you are saying and plus writing, then definitely you have to use comma. There should be a pause. In word series, continuously word series. Okay, next point is to separate phrases in series. Student, I already told you, if you don't know, let me tell you what phrase. So student, for example, we can say, tell me everything about yourself. Who are you? Where you have come from? Where are you going? So did I tell you the definition of clause? So let me tell you what clause is. Clause is also a group of words, but it has both subject and a matching verb, which is known as clause. Okay, so to separate short clauses in series, you have to use comma. After a noun of address, for example, Mrs. D'Souza, the head of the department, wants to meet you, everyone now. Danny, fetch the stick. Meaning of fetch is bring. Okay. So, there you can see noun, a noun of address. Mrs. D'Souza. It's a name of a person. So, that is noun. Okay. So, after this, you can use comma. To separate parts of a date or any words following the date. For example, November 28, 1958. November 28, comma. You have to put comma. So like that, you can use comma. Next is to separate expressions such as yes, no, oh, well, etc. For example, yes, that is Kali, and she has promised she will visit us soon. So whenever you are expressing your views by saying yes, no, oh, well, so there you guys will use comma. Okay, next is before coordinating conjunctions. For, and, nor, but, or, yet, so, that are used to introduce independent clauses. For example, the new girl is feeling lonely. So, let's see the next example. It was raining heavily, semicolon. We still went to school. She likes... Student, one slight mistake is there. It should be likes, okay, not like. Charles Dickens, semicolon, I like Jane Austen's work. We stayed away from the cobra, semicolon, we were scared of it. So this type of whenever you don't want to use any conjunctions, student, listen to me carefully, then you just have to use semicolon. Instead, if you are using conjunction, you don't have to use. So it is like to replace the conjunction. Next is to list a series of items that already have comma in them. The talent show will be conducted in New Delhi, comma, India, that is in India. Then next is Ethan,
that is in England, and Montreal, that is in Canada.
So, see, you can see the capital and the country. Capital and the country. So, like the in this way, you can see that we are using semicolon. Can you see it properly? Next is, the police have arrested Seema, an actor, semicolon, John, a producer, Siddharth, a singer, and Rekha, a newspaper reporter, for the crime. One person having profession, what they are. So after that, repeating the same with the others. So like that, we are showing list of series of items. So that is where we are using semicolon. Before conjunctions such as nevertheless, however, moreover, besides, otherwise. For example, he broke our windows twice in a week. However, we let him go because he is our neighbor. They were enemies, nevertheless, they worked together on this project. Now here you have to remember, note, do not capitalize word after semicolon unless they are special words that are always capitalized. Special words means, you know, it can be name of a person or a particular place. If it is proper noun, then you can use capital letters. Otherwise, you will not use. Okay. Now here you see, before conjunction, words are nevertheless, however, moreover, besides, otherwise. So it is showing that he broke our windows twice in a week. So however, we let him. However, this type of expressions, this type of conjunction, there you guys have to use semicolon.
So our next punctuation mark is colon. A colon is used sometime to introduce a list of things. Like, for example, you can say, bring these essentials to the camp. A few warm clothes, a pair of running shoes, first aid box, and a torch. So, whenever you are introducing list of things, you are going to use colon. And colon sign, you can see here, it's like that, double dot. So you need all of this to be a successful writer. Good grammar, vast vocabulary, creative thoughts, and a publisher friend. Another example of colon. Now next is, between independent clauses, when the second sentence explains, paraphrases, or expand the first sentence in some way. Like, for example, I can tell you, mother is in a bad mood, she had an argument with a client, and maid didn't turn up. So, in this way, you can see that independent clauses, they are talking, when they are talking, second sentence also explaining, so, or expanding in first, about the first sentence in some way, so there you can use semicolon. Now, last is, to indicate direct speech. You have seen while converting direct to indirect, indirect to direct speech in grammar, you have seen that it is very necessary over there. Colon you have seen. So my example is, my dad always said, work hard and be honest. So like that, you can see examples. Now here, one thing they are telling, do not capitalize word after colon unless they are special words. What are always capitalized or are quoted, said by a person. So, student, if it's a quotation, means if it is in the double inverted comma, then remember, you have to use
capital letter. Otherwise, you will not use. Okay? So, don't do this mistake.